What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be going over how you can set up and maybe even play on your own offline Minecraft server. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click that notification bell so you can stay up to date on every tutorial we upload, just like this one. In some cases, specific setups can encounter problems and players would be unable to join. These scenarios can be resolved by making an offline server, as this allows the ability to create networks so anyone can join in. Alternatively, some owners may want to increase Minecraft's accessibility to their friends, which is also solved by making the server offline. There's a few tasks to review before configuration, as issues can arise if you don't take the proper precautions before moving forward. The world's progression is going to stay the same, but the player's data will be reset when switching from online to offline mode. We strongly recommend joining the game and moving all player inventories into chests at memorable locations, as this is going to protect items from being completely removed from the server during the migration. Most server owners store their items near spawn, as this allows people to easily retrieve their loot after setting the server to offline. With this in mind, do this for all worlds and dimensions so everything is solved. Otherwise, creating a new world would work without issues. By far, the most important preparation measure is securing Minecraft connections, as you wouldn't want players to log in on admin or staff accounts. Additionally, offline servers are susceptible to bot attacks that ruin everything for real players, and setting up protection is crucial for worlds, users, and connections so no harm is done. A popular function is to force players to register with a password, making their account protected from someone else trying to access it. Other players may include verifying IP addresses, authorizing specific players, and more. Researching these add-ons might be challenging, so review our Finding Mods and Finding Plugins tutorials with written and video instructions to get started. And in some cases, plugins and mods may not fully work on offline servers due to them relying on UUIDs. This is an ID for every Minecraft account, which is used by Mojang's authentication services to validate player connections. Changing the modes will alter how these UUIDs are generated and used, making some plugins or mods reset specific player data. Double check your settings in their respective configuration file from FTP file access. These files are located inside the main plugins or mods folder. Then inside their specific folder, if you see any compatibility settings for offline servers, while you're looking at these files, go ahead and enable them, and then make sure to click on save to ensure the changes apply on the next restart. When you're done preparing everything, the final step is to make the server offline. This is an easier process compared to the last step. You can start off by heading to your Apex server panel and then clicking on the stop button, and then wait until your server is fully offline. Then click on the config files near the top left of the page. And once you're there, find the server settings section and then click on the online mode. And then change it from enabled to disabled in the drop-down menu. And when you've done this, you can scroll down and click on save to keep the changes. Now you can click on the name of your server at the top. And once you're here, click on restart to restart the server and apply the new mode. Be sure to check out the description of this video for the written guide that has not only pictures, but links to everything that we've mentioned, plus recommended mods and plugins for your offline server, with guides on how to install these mods or plugins to your server. Well, folks, that's all we've got for you today. And as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.